I had agusi, chicken suey, jollof, native rice.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I had, like, I was eating native rice. Like, it was, that was all I was eating.
Jadisola. Pack your bag. We're going. Henry on Kiss Fresh, and I'm joined by the one, the only, the stunning Jada Cheeves, aka Jada Wader. How are you, darling?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm very well. It's so lovely to have you in the studio.
No, I'm excited to be here.
You look beautiful.
Stop.
Stunning.
So do you.
Thank you so much, honey. We're going to get along just fine.
No. What's your sign?
I'm a Taurus. How about you?
I'm a Libra.
What does that mean for us?
I don't know.
Okay.
But I just want to know.
But at least we got it out there.
You give
there.
Like, you don't give Taurus.
Oh, really? What do
but
I give?
I don't really know Taurus. You kind of give like Sagittarius.
Ooh, okay.
Like fiery.
Oh, fiery. Yeah, it might be in there somewhere. You know, you get it out of me. It will come.
Right.
So how are you finding London so far, girl?
London is lit. Yeah. I'm really enjoying myself out here. It feels like home.
Yeah. And I know like you're here, but I just need to know how you're able to pull off these hot girl outfits in -100 degrees because it's freezing.
It's cold exactly like this in Atlanta.
Really?
Like seriously, it's super cold there. So whatever I look good in, forget the weather. I'll deal with that later.
Jacket or no jacket?
Something like.
Can I tell you what we do? Yeah.
Which I do.
All right, cool. So I'm from South London, and South London girls, we're known for being like a little bit more tough. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So even if the sexy outfit is underneath, know for a fact I'm wearing a trench coat.
A trench coat.
A puffer.
Hello.
Actually, I'm going to look so gangster. You're going to think I'm the bouncer. You're going to think I'm out there asking for ID, but no, the sexy outfit is underneath because it's too cold, girl.
It's cold, yeah.
It's freezing. Yeah. And I know it's not your first time here as well. One of the last times we saw you here, you linked up with Nicki Minaj in the club. What is it that Americans love about the London vibe?
We love the accents.
Okay.
That's my favorite.
Have you picked it up?
And
yeah.
I mean, I could do a little bit. You know, like something like, but and y'all like dance.
Yeah.
I love that. Like
fully.
Everybody is partying.
Mm-hmm.
We don't do that in the States. That's the only thing.
What's it like out there when it comes to parties?
Everybody is. It's like a fashion show.
Really?
Everybody's just going to stand around, pop bottles.
Tables. They're
gonna spend a lot of money.
Yeah.
They're gonna pop bottles. It's gonna be a lot of sparklers in the air. But yeah. Like dancing, we don't do
you
that.
You don't dance.
No. I mean, I do, but
yeah.
Like,
everybody
it's just
else.
Not like an everybody. Thing,
I hear that. I'm not gonna lie, here we definitely sweat on the dance floor.
I love that. Like I love that.
And I've seen you partying with the London girls as well.
Yes.
What is it that you love about UK girlies?
They're so like authentic.
Yeah.
And it's genuine, you know?
Mm-hmm.
In the States, I'm not gonna lie, like I'm a girl's girl, so I get along with girls, but here it's just like we sisters.
Yeah.
Like,
of course.
What's up? Like, come on, take a shot. Like, they were coming up just hugging me, you know?
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I'm a hugger, but like a lot of people don't be with hugs, but everybody I've been meeting here, they huggers.
Yeah,
I love that.
We're like, big huggers over here.
Hello, give me a hug.
And I love the fact that you said that you're a girl's girl. For you, what is like a notion that you get that someone's a girl's girl? How can you tell that someone is?
For instance, if I smile at you from across the room, you smile back.
Smile back.
Or you greet me with a hug, like things like that, you know? Because like,
absolutely.
That energy is just, it's like, contagious.
Mine is, if I've got a crumb on my face, let me know.
Oh my God, your zipper's unzipped. Like, sis.
Thank you.
Oh, turn around. Yo, make it. Like, stuff like
that. Do you
care?
I love it. And another one of mine is, if there's men around, don't change. Yeah.
If you do that, you're not my
girl. Oh my gosh. Things that you weren't saying yesterday, suddenly you're saying, because who? Jamal's in the room. Stop it.
Loser activity. No, for, I hate that. Oh my God, I hate that so bad.
Loser!
Yeah, like, loser.
For real. Cool. So, I don't know if you know, but apparently the South London girlies love you so much, yeah? And I want to see how well you'd fit into South London, being a southerner yourself.
Okay.
Right? So, I'm going to ask you a couple of questions. Number one, how good are you with confrontation?
Oh my God, I try to avoid it so much.
But if it just
but
happens,
if it come down to it, oh, I'm... firecracker. No, for real, it's bad. That's why I really try to avoid it because, like, when I go low.
So explain it to us. Don't tell us what you'd say, but explain it to us. What can we expect from a fiery Jada?
So, like, I'm not going to be yelling, but it's going to be, like, I might say the nastiest, darkest shit to the point it's just, like, you ate me up like that calmly. Like, I'm not going to, like, yell and get out of character, though. Like, I'm going to say something that's, like, real below the belt.
I'm even scared.
No, don't be scared. But that's why I avoid it.
I hear it.
You got it,
but
sis.
If confrontation is here, you know how to deal with it.
Yeah, of course.
Period. Okay, cool. I would like for you, because you need this if you're in South London, to give me your best screw face and kiss your teeth. Hello, darling. You're from Lewisham. You don't know. You're from South. It's very much given. And lastly, how far are you willing to travel to go to a party or to see a link? Because in South, we have terrible transport links.
Baby, I go anywhere for a link. Like, it's no limits on my links.
I'm going to scream.
If I know I'm going to have a good time when I get there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, no limits.
Welcome to South London.
Hello. Yeah. Hello.
Welcome, girl. I love it. And do you know what? Yeah, I seen online as well that you got gifted a Chanel bag.
That was so cute.
Please, tell us how that whole thing happened.
So I actually, like, they was trying to get me to leave out the club. And I'm like, I'm not ready to go. Like, my security like, let's go. I'm like, no. So I tricked them thinking I was like leaving out and I like snuck to the DJ booth.
Love it.
So I'm just standing at the DJ booth and they like, Jada, this guy is trying to gift you. So I'm like, where the gift at? He pulls out a Chanel bag.
You're
like the shopping bag. So I'm like, oh yeah, like come here. Like I want that. So he pulls it out. I'm thinking it's like maybe like a, you know, a necklace or something, something small, but like it's a box.
It's a whole box.
I said, oh yeah, let me see. Like, give it here. So they passing it over, trying to get it to me.
Yeah.
And I unboxed it in the club. Like, and I just couldn't believe it was like a classic flat bag. And I'm like,
that's crazy.
And it's the new one because I actually was gonna get that bag. I have the white one, but not the white with the purple hardware. So it was like, okay, that's real cute.
Whoever you are, we need to find you.
I found him. I posted on my Snapchat, like, who is he?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the guy apparently don't have like an Instagram, but like,
did he send you, like, the receipt? Like, babe, this was me that did it.
Yeah, the receipt was in the box. Like, what? I have everything.
That's great. And can I say something?
And I remember how his face looked because the girl who told me, like, this is him, she showed me a picture. I was like, oh, yeah, that's definitely him. I was like, tell him
that's
I said thank you so
nuts.
Much. Yeah, it was crazy.
And do you know why, baby? Because here, there's a stereotype, right, that we're quite stingy.
Stop.
I'm not going to lie.
Really?
Some people, I'm not going to say me, some people have suffered at the hands of stingy men, just in general.
Yeah.
So the fact that we know that men are out there, that London men, honestly, congratulations.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah, definitely.
For letting us know. Yeah.
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 Y'all top five on my list of places I visited, for sure.
I love it. So let's talk a little bit more about you as well. We already know that you're one of the original It Girls, and we've seen the TikTok, I'm going to be Jada Weda. Right? So let the people know, what does it actually take? Because you make it look effortless, but what does it actually take to be the It Girl?
I would just say to move with grace. Like, no matter what situation you're in, just always be yourself, be confident, and just show up as you, no matter who you're around, where you're going. Mm. I feel like confidence is key to just being me.
And of course.
Nobody can ever take that away from me. Even though they try, it's like, baby, I'm me.
I love that. You know? Even though they try, and girls, they do try, don't they?
They be trying to do a thing. They be trying. It's just like, all right, sis, I heard you. All right, next. Like, what?
I love it. Okay, and at what point in your career did you realize, like, yeah, I'm that girl. I'm her.
I wouldn't say a point in my career. It's just like, since I was a teenager, like a little girl, I've always just like, I knew who I was, you know, and I can't say like it's no certain thing in my life that has happened that made me feel that way. I kind of always felt that way.
Mm. So how do you build that confidence then? Because it's not as easy for everyone. So how do you do it?
Just learning myself, doing like the inner work to understand who I really am, and that's all that matters. Nothing else around me or what anybody have to say matter. Nothing they're saying it matters, but what I feel inside.
So. I like you. Yeah, you're great.
Stop.
I like it. And you do all of this whilst being a mother as well. Yes. We absolutely love to see it. How's motherhood been treating you?
I love my baby so much.
I know.
Like, he is like the easiest kid. Everybody's always like, you want more kids? And it's like, no, like I have the perfect kid. Yeah. Why would I go out and do that again? And it's not going to be the perfect kid. Like, you're not going to get a... two perfect kids, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, you never know.
No. Well, he's just too perfect. He's just too perfect. I don't want to do it again. Like, he's all I need.
Bless you. And what have you learned about yourself since becoming a mom?
I really established patience. Because, like, before, everything used to just, like, one small thing, I'm ready to, like, throw it all away.
Yeah.
But with the kid, you have to learn, like, patience. Because I fix your drink, it's going to spill. The old me, I would be like, going crazy, but it's like, okay, it's fine, son. Like, I'm gonna clean it up. Like, just chill.
Yeah.
So, like, patience for sure.
That's so cute. Jada, stunning. And I'm not gonna lie, Jada, my favorite side of you, I'm gonna call her Holiday Wader. Yeah, because she gives us so much great content. Yeah, we have to talk about you drunk in Dubai.
Oh my goodness.
Girl, number one, how did you end up so drunk? And number two, where did that shoe go?
Oh my God. So I ended up drunk because it was Des' birthday. Oh. And we have this thing, like, when it's my birthday, it's your birthday. When it's your birthday, it's my birthday.
Love it.
Every time Des, it's like a holiday or like her birthday, she get real emotional on her birthday. So I was like, girl, I'm drinking fuzz. I'm having time fuzz. You all that sad stuff you got going on, I'm gonna handle it. Yeah. I got so messed up.
Girl, we saw.
It was bad. No, like, it was bad. And then everybody is like, this place is so strict. Like,
honestly,
you're doing it in the wrong place. Because I never get out my body how I got out my body in Dubai.
We would have thought it was your birthday times 10.
No, literally. It was bad.
Do you know what I was going to say? Were you not scared? Because in Dubai, they'll put you away forever. No joke.
No, really, they would. But, like, the hotel we stayed at, we saw all type of stuff in that hotel. They loved us. They, like, lived for it.
Okay.
So when we got in the hotel, they, like, make sure we were good. They weren't tripping on us.
Okay, first.
I was toe up. Like, we know,
yeah. First
and
last
the shoe,
time.
I could. So shark boots, girls. If you got shark boots, you already know getting them things on and off is a killer.
Yes.
I paid my friend to take off my boots for $1,000.
You didn't.
I did you because didn't. I was like, I don't want to deal with it. I'm so drunk. I just want to lay down when I get in the room.
Jada, if you're giving out £1,000, yeah, to take off shoes, I'm here.
Because I wanted them off so bad.
What?
She only got one off. She ended up getting another one off when we got in the hotel room. No. But yeah,
it's the way that you collapsed on the floor as well in your one shoe. You had a time.
That wasn't me. That wasn't me.
And speaking of holidays, girl, recently we saw Holiday Wader in Nigeria for Dirty December. First of all, who put you onto the Nigerian vibes? Because I want to shake their hand.
I was just going through like my top cities on my Instagram.
Yeah.
And it was New York, Lagos, Chicago, and then Houston.
Yeah.
And then Atlanta was somewhere on there. But Lagos was number two. So I'm like just looking. I'm like, what the heck? Like, let me look into this. And then I went to top countries. And it was United States, Nigeria, United Kingdom.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, so I've been to United Kingdom. I want to go to Nigeria. Like, that was like something I wanted to accomplish before 2023 ended.
Yeah.
I went over there and it just was like such a vibe.
I can tell.
Like, I really had so much fun.
Yeah, that's what everyone says when they go back home. Yeah. Honestly, like, they have the best time ever. Because if there's one thing about Nigerians, we know how to party.
Are you Nigerian?
I'm half Nigerian, half Sierra Leonean. Yeah.
Okay, y'all know how to party.
Oh, we know, yeah.
Like, it was crazy. I had so much fun.
Did they give you a Nigerian name yet?
I have a couple. So we got Jade.
Yeah.
And then Jedesola.
Oh, Jadesola.
Jadesola. Yeah. I'm like, okay. Like, they really call me that. They literally call me that.
Jadesola. Oh, yes. My
so
days.
I got a couple.
I love it. Are you ready for a Nigerian passport, you reckon?
Yeah. I'm ready. Give it to me.
I love it. So now that you've experienced it, yeah, what do you love about Nigerians and Nigerian culture?
The food.
Mm-hmm.
I love the food.
What did you eat?
I had egusi, chicken suya, jollof. With native rice.
Yeah.
I had, like, I was eating native rice. Like, it was, Jadesola. That was all I was eating.
Jadesola. Pack your bag. We're going. And I know that you like Nigerian music as well.
Yeah.
Because I've seen you vibe to Odumodi Black and Charlie Poppy's cast.
Yes.
What is it you love about that song?
It just make you want to dance. I don't know. I can't explain it. They music, the beats. It's just, you want to stand up and dance
of
and
course.
Party. I love the music. I love everything about it. And then you got to think, like, both of my camera guys that I use, like, who've been with me for years, they're both Nigerian.
Love
so they always be trying to, like, put me on, like, Jada, you gotta go to Nigeria, da da da.
Yeah.
So they've been saying it for years. So the fact that I actually went and I'm always around it, like, I've been eating fufu with my camera guy.
You're joking.
Yes, like, nawau. Like, he tells me all the slang and stuff.
Oh,
swear.
My gosh, wait, what did you say?
Nawau.
Nawau.
Like, he be putting me on. Jada, put this on your... So, like, I've been into it. So, to actually go and experience it, it was, like, such a vibe.
No, I need to know what other, like, kind of words you've picked up now.
It's so many, like...
Have you heard of Omo? Yeah, Omo.
Yeah, and then you trying to bugat me.
You're trying to what now?
Bugat me. It's so many. It's so many, I know. It's just like, okay.
Can I say something? You're Jadesola for real. Yeah, okay. We're claiming you. That's just right, that's bet. Just what it is now. I need to let you know about Henry's Hotline, which is a safe space, yeah, for you to just let off your chest anything that could be irking you, anything that's annoying you. So, Jada Cheeves, what would you like to bring to Henry's Hotline?
One thing I despise in people is, like, lying. Like, you just don't have to lie.
have you seen that TikTok? I hate when people lie.
Yeah, it's like, just tell the truth.
Yeah.
It's way easier than lying. Then you gotta keep lying to back up your lie. Mm-hmm. Like, that's just one of my pet peeves.
Do you know what it is about me? I am not a good liar in general. Let's say even if I do tell a lie, you can see it on my face.
Right.
That I'm lying. I'm a true liar. Mm-hmm. And so I feel like if you can see it on my face, other people's faces, I can also tell you when you're lying,
yes,
babe.
Exactly. It's so easy.
Especially when you know the truth. When you know the truth and someone's lying to you, do you keep it to yourself or do you like say like, no, I know you're lying, babe?
It'd just be like a mental note, but like, you a liar in my book. Like, you always a liar to me.
I'll never tell you to your face, but I know up here.
Yeah, like, I got it. Mental note. I'll move accordingly.
Liars is what we're going to be chucking into Henry's hot light. Yeah. Okay. Liars, this is for you. Jada hates you.
Hate you.
So Jada, before we let you go, is there anything that's coming up that we should know about, that we should be checking in on?
So wait a minute. I have my Valentine's collection dropping next. It's real cute. Lingerie. And we're even adding in like briefs, boxer briefs for the guys.
Wow.
So yeah, I'm really excited.
So for February the 14th, everyone's going to be patterned.
Yes. Yeah. Hello.
All thanks to Jada.
Wait a minute.
I love it. Jada Cheeves, honestly, thank you so much for joining
me. Thank you for having
me. Been a pleasure. You are a darling, and I cannot wait to have you back on the show.
Thank you. I will be back.
Oh, period.
I will be back.